Hey, quick question. Have you ever had one of those days when you're doing your follow-up and you're chasing people for answers and you think, now, did I send that an email? Did I leave a voicemail message? Did I send it on WhatsApp? Did I send them a text? Did I send them a Slack message? You get the drift, right? It's so hard to keep track of everything. So when I stumbled across a tool that promised to simplify all of that, well, naturally I had to test it. I couldn't wait to share it with you. Now it's called ZenZap and I've been using it for the past couple of weeks and yeah, it kind of lives up to the hype. It's made communication an absolute breeze and I want to talk you through the pros, the cons and give you a preview of what it all looks like and how you can use it in your workflow. This video has been sponsored by ZenZap, but they've asked me to share my honest opinion. So do you want to see what it's all about? I'm going to share with you a quick run through of my favorite features of ZenZap in the web version, the desktop version, primarily. As you can see, the immediate interface is super clean and super uncluttered. It's like a really pared down inbox, which I really love, compared to the chaotic interface of WhatsApp, which is really just purely, you know, the chats on the left-hand side and nothing much else. You got a little widget at the top with your agenda because it's connected to your Google account or your calendar. So I've got it connected to mine. I've got a very quick snapshot view of what's ahead for the week. And then on the left-hand side, some extra filters and favorites like chats, unread, starred, DMs, etc. Let's have a quick look how you might set up a group discussion. Now, this might be for internal colleagues to be able to just communicate on particular topics, or you might want to invite external colleagues and partners as well, depending on the discussion topic. I'm going to create something new for, say, a client of mine. Let's say my client was Nestle, and I want to create a channel where I can just communicate what's going on with the customer to those internally who need to know. So operations, product, marketing, maybe my manager, support teams, things like that. So I'm just going to call this Nestle Hub. All right, so we've got our hub here. If I want to invite people to it, I can. I could just drop a message. So let's say I wanted to share Nestle's full-year results. So I could just drop that. Something like, hey, you know, results have dropped. Sounds really exciting. Here's the headline news and here's the results if you want to go and check it out yourself. I could then add some to-dos. Let's say I wanted to do some white space analysis with the marketing and the sales team. I could just quickly set up a to-do, assign it to myself or to other people, and click add. And now I've got a reminder and very easily can set up as many things as I need to set up to be able to stay organized and keep the team organized and informed as well. Okay, so let's take a quick look at the to-do list, right? So I just assigned myself that action with marketing to be able to do some white space analysis. If I want to then revisit all of the to-dos that I have in my action items, I've got this combined list here, which is fantastic. So easy to just see what's overdue, what's due soon, and what's been assigned to me and everything at once. So I can filter these. So if I've assigned things to other people, or if they've been assigned from other people, super easy to filter. And I can also filter by topic. So it automatically groups and assigns topics and categories to help you stay organized. So if I'm thinking, all right, I need to know what's due for Nestle, easy. I can very quickly think, okay, that's my most important account. What's outstanding? Check it out. Done. So much better than WhatsApp where you've got to like scroll through and it's all on your phone. It's very difficult to find when you're searching for things. So I love this feature to really find stuff quickly. Contacts works just like anything else. You've got a profile here that pops up really easily in line. You can very easily make an appointment. How about I want to meet at Thursday at 6 or 6:30? I could go create and it's going to send Ryan a meeting. And it's actually connected the Google chat room as well. So how easy is that? A meeting request sent in no time at all. So I love that feature as well. I could call directly from here as well. So I don't have to jump in and out of my applications to be able to contact him if I wanted to. What's also really great is that you've got this ability to click on a message and turn it into something else. So for example, this meeting request, this note that I sent to him, I could forward it to somebody or I could add a to-do related to that particular comment that they made. So that would really help me to be able to, again, transfer what happens in the chat into an action item like that with one click. It makes client collaboration and internal collaboration smoother than ever. Everyone's in the same workspace, nothing falls through the cracks. It's going to reduce clutter. It's going to kill email chains and it keeps everything in context. What I also love is that it's been built for 9-to-5 life. It was purpose-built for this exact idea of keeping people focused, keeping people communicating, collaborating, project management, task management, calendar integrations. It's not just a social app, we know, with some to-do lists slapped on, you know? It was designed for real work. The great thing about this too is it is secure. It is locked down. ZenZap takes privacy very seriously. I also love that it divides work and, you know, personal life and professional life, right? If I'm jumping into WhatsApp, then I know it's only for my friends and my family. I go to ZenZap to work. Here are a few things that you might want to keep in mind. Now, these aren't deal breakers as far as I'm concerned, but worth noting. Now, as tempting as it may be just to sign up and get going, if you are a bigger company, you're going to want to check your IT policy and check with IT before rolling it out, especially if you're in a heavily regulated industry. You want to make sure that you tick all the right compliance boxes and everything is set up smoothly. And of course, ZenZap is still growing. So while their integration list is solid and they've got all the big players checked, like Slack, Teams, Office, Google, and Salesforce and HubSpot, you know, if you use some niche tools, you may need to double check what's actually supported right now. Now, if you're excited to get started, the best news is that you can try it for free forever. And if you want the full feature set, paid plans start at £2 per user, which is a no-brainer if it saves you even 1 hour of Slack, email, WhatsApp tag. So what do you think? You want to give it a spin? So the links are below, as well as check out this QR code. And big thanks to ZenZap for sponsoring this and letting me test drive their platform. I'm going to be sticking around for a while. I love it. Now, if you've got any questions or you're curious how it stacks up against what you're using now, drop a comment. I'd love to hear your thoughts, and I answer all my comments on this channel. So I'll get you an answer. Check out my next video, which is all about how to grow your influence at work so people help you and do their job so you can do yours. Thank you so much for watching. Like, share, subscribe, you know the drill. And I'm going to catch you in the next one real soon.